players, and we proudly present to you that classic tale of tragedy, Hamlet. Now, normally Hamlet runs about 3 hours, but because we're all eager to go see the Big Bad musical, we've been asked to condense it to about 30 minutes. We'll do our best.
Betrayal.
This is the story of a sword fight.
Oh, wait till you see the sword fight. See, Femke and I did stage combat workshops with some of the sword and just kick her.
Thank you. As I was saying, this is the story of Hamlet, Prince of Denmark.
Excuse me, it's Hamletta, Princess of Denmark.
Yeah!
Actors, prepare yourselves. Attention! Acting drills! Laugh! Now cry! Oh, you're angry, you're so angry! Hey, you're falling in love! On your marks, get set, action! A long, long time ago, in a country far, far away, Denmark.
What?
She went somewhere else.
Well,
what am I supposed to do?
Put this on.
Oh.
lines, right?
We beseech you, Hamlet, remain here and comfort your eyes with cheer.
The money I paid for tuition.
You were
the
I'll have these players play something like Murder of My Father Before My Uncle. blench, I'll know my course. The place the thing, where an owl catch the conscience of the king.
Not ready yet.
He's calling!
To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take up arms against the sea of troubles by imposing anthem. Does anyone have something?
I have a math problem.
If a train leaves London at 30 miles per hour, and a train leaves Dover at 20 miles per hour, and a fly flies in between them at 60 miles per hour, who's buried in Grant's tomb?
Foul! Inappropriate use of anachronism and a math word problem in a Shakespearean play!
Who?
break.
Hi. Oh!
And finds his father dead.
Oh, Arthur, you're dead.
And his sister's dead too.
Oh, sister, you're dead too.
And he blames Hamlet.
It must have been Hamlet.
The king formulates an evil and cunning plan.
I have an evil and cunning plan.
Why, yes. Yes, I should. And I'm a...
Ha! So, the king arranges a duel between Laertes and Hamletta, giving Laertes a poisoned sword to help him win. But he also poisons a glass of wine for Hamletta to drink, just in case. But forgets to tell his wife. Meanwhile, there's also this guy, Fortinbras. He's from Norway, and he's invading Denmark, because in this little-known subplot, like, he's actually the one who's supposed to be the king.
Good grief, even Tolkien can follow this plotline!
Yes, okay. You're dead.
Oh, yeah. Gentlemen, today we have a fight. Very, very nice fight tonight. Are you people ready?
Yeah!
Are you ready?
Yeah!
On my right, we have son of Polonius, sister Ophelia, we have Laertes! On my left, we have a prince. He's mad. He thinks he's a girl. Hamletta!
Come on.
Oh, one for me.
I'll be your foil, Laertes. In my ignorance, your skill shall, like a star in the darkest night, stay fiery off indeed.
You mock me, sir.
That's ma'am to you.
Yeah. Well, I'm not pitying a girl.
Then it's going to be a quick fight.
Yes.
Out there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I'm not leaving that one, 6, 7,
noble heart, Prince Hamlet, let the angels take thee to the sky.
Lords and ladies, we thank you for your ears. So this tale told throughout the years, we have run the gamut for this tale of Prince Hamlet.
Oh!